Hi, I'm Chris, welcome to Cheshire Lines, and I recently had a question about the helices that I have on the railway that take trains from the top layer down to my fiddle yard. Now I've got two helices, one at either end of the railway, which bookmark the fiddle yard, so you can go through the fiddle yard and up one, come round and then go back down it to enter the fiddle yard on the other side. So this is a short video showing a train traversing from the top to the bottom through both helixes. Each helix has two tracks on it, a third radius and a second radius track. So I'll talk more about that once you've seen how the trains go round through the yard by the helixes. Okay. So now that you've seen how a train traverses from main lines, round the helixes, through the fibre yard and back up again, you can see the exits and entrances are disguised in tunnel mouths. I first put the helixes in when I first built the railway. So they're some of the first things to go in after the fiddle yard. And that's because I've built up and around on top of the helixes so that you can't see them. So what have I learned now that I've been operating the railway for a couple of years? So if I could have avoided helixes, I would have done so, but it's really hard to provide enough space between the fiddle yard and the main lines to be able to get in and manage any derailments. So I was kind of stuck with having them. Going for helixes that had two tracks on them, a third and second radius, I don't think I would do that again. I think I'd have one track and I would make it fourth radius. The second and third make it quite hard for particularly steam locomotives to run up and down them with heavy loads. But they do provide a great way of managing that height and distance. So they don't come without a lot of hard work and putting the track on them, but I would definitely now go for fourth radius ones. So, hope that helps and gives you a view of how the helixes work here, and I'll see you again soon.